Hi there. In this lesson, we're talking about unit rates. First, we're going to learn what unit rates are. Second, we're going to learn how to find the unit rate. Coming up on the Math Review. So first of all, what exactly is a unit rate? Well, a unit rate is a special kind of rate that's measuring out of every one unit. And since it's out of every one unit, that means this rate is going to have a one in the bottom. Rates have a top and a bottom, and a unit rate's bottom is always one. Now that we know what it is, and we know something about how it looks, the next thing we need to ask is, well, how exactly do we find a unit rate? Well, we divide by the bottom to find the unit rate. And so far, all we've had is words, and math is one of those things that's a lot easier to learn from example. So let's go to our first one. Let's say we have this here. This rate says you can travel 75 miles in 3 hours. This is usually how a rate will appear in a word problem. But when you're using calculations, you're more likely to use it as a fraction. And that would look like this, with the 75 miles on top of the 3 hours. So like I said before, this is a rate. But we're looking for a unit rate. And if we're looking for a unit rate, the question we're asking is, how far do you travel in every 1 hour? Knowing that we can travel 75 miles in 3 hours is great, but that's just a rate. A unit rate will tell us how far in miles you go in every 1 hour. And in order to find the unit rate, we're going to have to divide by the bottom value. And that's the number 3. So let's set up our long division. 75 as our top number is getting divided, which means it's going to go inside the long division notation house. Then I'll put the line here and a line here. And then since we're dividing by 3, that will go outside. So how many times can 3 go into 7? Well, 3 can go into 7 2 times. 2 times 3 is 6. When I subtract that, I get 1. And the next thing I need to do is bring down the 5. That gives us 15. And 3 can go into 15 5 times. Because 5 times 3 is exactly 15. And when I subtract that, I get 0. And that 0 remainder tells us we're done. And it gives us our answer. But what exactly does this mean? Well, this means we can travel 25 miles for every 1 hour. And this is our unit rate. Sometimes you'll see it written in words, and it'll look just like this. Most times, you'll write it like this, but all times, you'll read it like this. Let's look at our next example. Let's say that we know 100 students can fit in 5 buses. Again, this is how you would normally see it in the word problem. But in its usual form, it would look like this, with 100 students in the top of the rate, and the 5 buses in the bottom of the rate. Now again, this is a rate, but we're talking about unit rates. So how do I turn this into a unit rate? If you said divide by 5, you're absolutely right. And that's going to end up telling us how many students can fit in 1 bus, because it's a unit rate, and it's out of every 1 unit. So, let's get to work. we're going to have to divide 100 by 5. So 5 can go into 1, but 5 can go into 10. And how many times can that happen? Well, that would be 2. Because 2 times 5 is exactly 10. I'll subtract, that'll give me 0, and I still have a digit to go over, so I'll bring that 0 down. 5 goes into 0, 0 times, which will give me 0, I'll subtract, and that gives me 0 again. So we're done. But what exactly does this mean? This means that 20 students, because that's the top of our rate, can fit in every one bus. This means that we've got 20 students per bus. As a rate, it would look like this. You might see it like this, where it says 20 students over bus. You might see it like this, 20 students over one bus. But you'll always read it like this. So for this problem, our unit rate would be 20 students per bus. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time on the Math Review.